हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। तो कल तक हमने पार्ट थ्री तक देख लिए थे करंट अफेयर्स के यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स फॉर द इकोलॉजी एंड एनवायरमेंट सब्जेक्ट। सो टुडे वी विल डीलिंग विद पार्ट फोर एंड इवन टुडे वी विल बी डीलिंग विद इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड द कन्वेंशंस। दिस इज द फाइनल पार्ट। सो लेट अस गो अहेड एंड सी दिस कंटेंट फॉर द डे, राइट? सो आज हम ये कॉमन बट डिफरेंशियल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, दिस इज इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज, ये प्रिंसिपल क्या है उसके बारे में देख लेंगे। उसके बाद वी विल सी अबाउट द IUCN रेड लिस्ट ऑफ द थ्रेटन्ड स्पीशीज। लेटर वी विल लुक एट द हांगकांग कन्वेंशन। उसके बाद हम यूनाइटेड नेशन इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, हाउ इट इज न्यूज इन वेट इज इन न्यूज इन रीसेंट पास्ट एंड वॉट इट्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन। लेटर वी विल लुक एट द यूरोपियन इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक टू स्टॉप फॉसिल फ्यूल फंडिंग। वी विल ऑल्सो लुक एट वन स्पेशलिस्ट ग्रुप कॉल्ड एज एशियन एलिफेंट स्पेशलिस्ट ग्रुप। सो दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ IUCN एंड वॉट इज इट्स रोल एंड वॉट इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू। And finally, we will look at the adaptation fund, right? So the first one, so common but differential responsibilities and respective capabilities. See, post-industrialization, ये क्या हुआ था? So the developed countries took the advantage of the industrial revolution 1 and 2. However, equally they have the greater responsibilities for the producing the greenhouse gases. And if we see certain statistics, we see that for the developed countries it is almost 10 times more than the developing countries in the context of the carbon footprint. So in this context, this principle of common but differential responsibility is very much important. So this has origin in Kyoto Protocol. Now India still pursuing this particular principle in Paris Agreement 2, right? So there are two division of countries, that is Annex 1 and non-Annex 1. So generally Annex 1 countries are the developed countries and non-Annex 1 are the developing countries. So Annex 1 countries have a greater mitigation role to play, right? So as I said, it has its inception in Kyoto Protocol. If you look at the extra points, we see that in Paris agreements there is INDC, that is intended national determined contribution. So yahan pe kya hota hai, every country in its own capabilities say this is our contribution towards the Paris agreement, and they submit this report to the UNFCCC, right? And according to that, their policies, respective policies will be there. And recently we have seen that the CDM, that is the Clean Development Mechanism, will be replaced by Sustainable Development Mechanism. This is yet in process, we have to update this later, right? So abhi tak kya hai Clean Development Mechanism? So it has carbon credits, adaptation fund. So carbon credits kya hota hai? Generally developed countries on its role to reduce its to reduce its carbon footprint and bearing its historical responsibility, it will exchange with the greener projects in the developing countries. So they will be buying these carbon credits, right? So that fund that has been given to the developing countries will be utilizing to promote other green projects, right? Similarly, a part of this carbon credits, it is nearly 2%, that is being used for the adaptation fund. So this adaptation fund is for the developing countries to adapt to the climate change. For example, it might be in agriculture sector where we will be where the policies will be aimed at sustainable agriculture and or the climate resilient agriculture, right? So the next topic is regarding the red list of the threatened species that is given by the IUCN. So recently nearly 2000 new species has been added to this. So how these species are recognized? There is a certain criteria. There are 5 factors, that is the rate of population decline, what is the geographical range, what is its population size, how small is population size, and how much it is restricted to the particular area, whether it is extinct in the wild, what is its probability of getting extinct, right? So depending on this five criteria, they will be categorizing, right, from the not evaluated to the extinct. उसमें द मोर इम्पोर्टेंट इज द क्रिटिकली एंडेंजर्ड एंडेंजर्ड एंड वल्नरेबल स्पीशीज, दीज थ्री कम अंडर द थ्रेटन्ड स्पीशीज लिस्ट, राइट. सो इफ यू सी द एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग द IUCN, इट इज हेड क्वार्टर इज एट स्विट्जरलैंड एंड रिमेंबर दिस इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ UN. UPSC tends to ask these kind of questions, whether this particular organization is a part of UN or it's a regional institute, etc. Right? So please look at the nature of the particular organization. And finally, the red list is also a key indicator for sustainable developmental goals and the Aichi targets. What is Aichi targets? These targets are the initiative or the part of the convention on biodiversity, right? So the next topic is about the this we have already discussed. So the next topic is about the Hong Kong International Convention for Safe and Environmentally Sound Recycling of the Ships. So this convention has taken place in 2009 and adopted by the International Maritime Organization. So what does it deal with? It deal with the recycling ships. So when we are recycling any product, especially in this context here ships, what is this threat to the environment, how it is impacting the human health and safety, right? So this convention deals with these things. However, this is yet to come into the force, and extra points regarding ships here. See, there is another convention called as the Ballast Water Management Convention. So first, what is ballast water? Ballast water is a water that is used in the ships to balance the ships when it is traveling from one port to another port. What happens is, generally when the cargo when a cargo or a big ship carries certain weight and takes out that weight in another port, so to balance that particular weight, they will put certain water inside the body of the ships, right? So that water is called as ballast water. So what happening here is, they are taking a water from particular one port, from one particular region which has one particular certain kind of species, and they are releasing that water in other port which is in completely geographical another biome might be, right? So because of this, they are discharging biological materials, different flora and fauna, kind of virus and bacteria into particular areas. So this is affecting the human health, like there have been instances where it has introduced new types of diseases like cholera in the recent many decades before. Similarly, if we look at the plants, there have been instances that it has introduced certain invasive species which is very much danger for the local biodiversity. For example, they have significant impact on the coral reefs. Okay, so this is regarding the Ballast Water Management Convention, right? So this has adopted by the International Maritime Organization in 2004. So the next topic is regarding the United Nations in Industrial Development Organization. So recently it is in news with the association with the National Institute of Solar Alliance it has taken up an initiative for developing the skill in the solar thermal energy sector, right? So this is already part of association of ongoing project between our Ministry of Renewable Energy and UNIDO and the Global Environment Facility, right? So this is contributing to replace the conventional fuels, we know the coal, diesel, oil, etc. So some more points regarding this organization. This is a specialized organization of United Nations, yes. Later, it promotes for the industrial development. It aims at reducing the poverty, inclusive globalization and environment sustainability. So its mission is to promote inclusive and sustainable industrial development. Okay. So the next topic is regarding the European Investment Bank. So this is a kind of a regional bank, like we have the New Development Bank for the BRICS, right? So they have taken an initiative to stop the fossil fuel funding. So they have set 2021 as the final year, and according to this new policy, they will be promoting only those kind of projects which per 1 kilowatt hour of energy production will not be producing not more than 250 grams of CO2, right? However, this is not applicable for the gas-based energy projects. Additional information regarding the same, recently in the news, we see that the Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency, along with this organization, got a loan agreement for the renewable energy projects in India. Similarly, this is promoting, it is giving funding for the Bangalore Metro Rail project, phase 2, right? The next topic is regarding the IUCN specialist group called as the Asian Elephant Specialist Group, right? What does it do? It generally aims at studying, management, monitoring and conservation of Asian elephants, okay? So recently there has been a meet of this specialist group in Malaysia. So here they discussed about the national action plan, how to conserve this particular species, right? So this is a global network. And this is a part of SSC, that is a Species Survival Commission of IUCN itself, right? And they biannually release one journal called as Gaja. So the last topic for the day, that is the Adaptation Fund. So this is established under the Kyoto Protocol of UNFCCC. So what does it do? This finances the projects to help the vulnerable communities in the developing countries to adapt for the climate change, right? So this might be in any sector, might be the agriculture or any other skill development, or the other skill in the manufacturing, etc. So what happening is this fund has a partial amount that is coming from as a part of the CER under CDM. We have seen. CDM is the clean development mechanism under Kyoto Protocol. So under this, there is a certified emission reductions. Okay, so this is nothing but the carbon credits. So whatever amount that has been occurring from these emission reductions, out of that 2% goes to this particular adaptation fund. Additionally, government and the private donors are also support this fund. So this fund will be used for these kind of projects helping the vulnerable communities, right? And here the World Bank serves as a trustee. See, World Bank also serves as a trustee for the GEF. It's one of the trustee of the GEF, okay? And so far it has directed more than like 532 million for the more than 80 concrete projects, right? And we also seen that recently in news that sustainable development mechanism will be replacing this clean development mechanism, okay? So we already discussed this in our first class, so please just revise that. So please do share your feedback and please use your time very judiciously. Thank you. Have a good day.